Today, I'm hitting up the French Riviera, and I found myself in the city of Cannes, famous for its luxury shops, restaurants, and hotels. As you all know, Cannes happens to be the home of the Cannes Film Festival, which is one of the most prestigious and publicized film festivals in the world. Every year, A-listers come here to brush shoulders and check out all the hot new releases on the film circuit. Oh, and look! There's Kung Fu Master himself! Jackie Chan! But I'm not here to shop or watch movies. I'm here to brush shoulders with an A-list footballer who's making waves for Tottenham Hotspur. I'm here to check out Louis Saha on holiday in his villa right here in France. Okay, so the film festival is in full swing, there's a sense of grandeur in the air, but I have to say goodbye to my friends Louis V, Courtier, and Dolce. I'm headed north into the hills surrounding Cannes where Saha and his family come to get away to rest in their modest holiday villa.
Alright, Skye, you okay?
I'm good, man, I'm good.
Okay, let you in.
Cool.
Yeah, good.
How are you?
I'm good,
Yeah, nice pleasure.
Thank you for having me, man. I appreciate it. And thank you for being on Gold Diggers.
Yeah.
Africa, Louis Saha.
Louis is no stranger to the English Premier League, having played for the likes of Manchester United, also known as the Red Devils, Everton and Spurs. The brother has made a name for himself and isn't stopping anytime soon. With White Hart Lane, his new home, he plans to make the move from Manchester to London in the near future. And having this house makes things very convenient too. I mean, the brother does play for the French national team, y'all.
Oh, man.
Yeah?
Oh, you got a lovely home.
Let me show you my family.
Oh, yeah. Family this side.
Yeah.
Bonjour.
How are you?
Good.
Bonjour, how are you? Bonjour.
Oh, man, you have a beautiful family.
Real, huh?
Real, yeah. Yeah, no, it's great. I think that it's very graceful. I really like the no aggressiveness on this.
This is amazing. This is really nice. Is this where you... You and your family spend most of your time with breakfast?
Yeah, breakfast and just have some meals. Like, you know, you talk, you know, with the kids, you know. It's really nice, yeah.
Isn't it funny how times have changed? I'm sure when you grew up as well, your mom and dad wouldn't allow you to have a TV next to the table where you eat. Because, like, hey, eat first, then watch TV.
Yeah, all changed now, huh?
Yeah. Dude, you have an indoor pool as well.
Yeah, lucky, man. I think you just... safer for the kids, you know, yeah. Especially sometimes it could be raining, so...
Do you do much swimming yourself? Try and live that whole, they don't say black people can't swim, you know, we have to try and...
I think I'm not too bad, you know, I try to make sure that I win some race, you know.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Cool, man, let's see your supper out here in the kitchen, already out.
I think it's ready for the carbonara, seems to be.
What's your kind of dish?
West Indies, Caribbean foods, you know, I like that, and I'm lucky, you know, my missus can really cook really well, so yeah.
The missus can really cook. Yeah. Question is, Louis, can you cook?
Whoa, I can do eggs.
You know what? I don't trust. Just now, you know, he's trying to trick us, guys. He's taking some of the food out. I'm not convinced. Yeah. I want to see what else you have in your kitchen.
You can find some sweets, you know, like, yeah, for sure. I'm a sweet person, so I try to hide them a little.
It's actually the Cannes Film Festival that's happening right now in France. Do you watch a lot of movies?
Yeah, I do. I really enjoy the time, you know, in front of the TV. Yeah, I've got the theater, so I'm...
You have a theater?
Yeah,
that's all I needed to know. Let's go, man. Let's go. I want to check that out. Ooh, this is one big picture. What's with the pigeon, though?
Yeah, it's a It's a picture from UNICEF, you know, and it's a nice message, you know. I don't want to be scared to leave my children fly on their own.
Well, now with the pigeon, explain the whole picture. Like, you know, you're half naked on it. Were you fully naked?
Yeah, no. Don't start, my man. No, it's more about, you know, the children, you know, being represented by the Colombian. It's just like, I don't want to be scared to leave my children, you know, live their own life, you know, so.
It's time for a quick music break. So while we go downstairs to Louis Cinema, put on your dancing shoes, and we will see you on the other side.
Thank you.
That's right. You locked on Gold Diggers, baby. And today I'm on the French Riviera in the city of Cannes, chilling with football striker Louis Saha, who's living at large. I mean, the guy's got his own cinema, y'all. Enough said.
Ah, you even got a VIP carpet, man, you know? VIP up in here. Wow, now this is a nice room, man. I can understand a VIP carpet up in there.
Yeah, no, it's
jeez,
nice,
man, this is nice, son. Wait, is that Gwizzy Vuju?
Yeah, yes, legend.
And then now the nakedness hasn't stopped again.
What's going on?
That's a big picture of you, unfortunately.
Just naked. Show the gym walk, you know? Yeah, try to show my arm is bigger than you.
Comparing muscles.
Yeah, exactly.
No, but it's a very nice picture, man. That's one of our legends back home as well. You obviously spend a lot of time here with your family?
Not really. Try to do my tournaments of PlayStation sometimes.
But your FIFA.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's a great game, you know?
Yeah, and you're on the game. Why wouldn't you play it?
Yeah, and, yeah, that's something that's special, you know?
Yeah. You got a bongo drum. Do you play that?
Try it.
Okay. Is it? I want to see that. Huh? Come on, you must show me. You say you can play it. Well, let's see you play it, man. Come on. Try your true African style. What do you have with it if you're not going to play it?
Yeah, just I'm going to get it, you know. You need to have time for that.
So just the wife for it. Hey, baby. Wait, hey, I see your books here. I actually wanted to talk to you about these, man. Thinking Inside the Box, Reflections on Life as a Premier League Footballer. My man. What a nice pool area, dog. Jeez,
yeah,
man. Spend a lot of time here.
No, yeah, it's brilliant.
You know, I can actually see you writing your books here.
That's an inspiration.
It's great. Tell me about this.
I find, like, very therapy in, you know, in a way, so it really helped me to get a better look at my career and how I can help the youngsters, so I really enjoyed writing it.
How long did it take you?
It was long, yeah. 2 years and a half writing the book and all that, but it was one moment I just started and my missus dropped some coffee on the computer.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it was bad.
But I mean, it was still all fresh in the, you know what I mean?
Not really. It took me like maybe a year to get inspiration and, you know, get the motivation back. So yeah, it was like a long 4 years of writing and editing. The great thing about the commitment on the book is obviously to give half of the revenue to the charity. So I really wanted to participate to the great fight, you know, against local dystrophy, because it's a brain disease where children get you know, in trouble, and I really think that was a great cause.
Especially, I mean, with kids as well, you know, you obviously thinking about if that had to happen to them.
Exactly, yeah. So when I see them, you know, every day and being in good health, you know, I see how lucky I am. And I write that book to make people realize that even we are footballers and privileged people, we still think about people who are suffering, because football is not the only thing on earth.
Now, there's a lot of people in Africa that watched Gold Diggers, man. How can they get in touch with your charity or probably make donations if they wanted to?
At the end of the book, I've got a picture of the logo, so it's that
right
thing
there.
You know, it's right there, Hila, and you got the website.
So if you guys want to get in touch with the charity or want to make a small donation to the man who's doing great things,
that's perfect.
Here it is. It's simple as that.
Yeah.
All right, well, man, I'm
you.
Really humbled by, you know, the work that you're doing, writing
thank
a book,
you
know, being part of charity. All right, man, I want to check out your clothes, whatever it is that you got. Let's see it. Look at this man, he says he doesn't wear a lot of clothes or has a lot of clothes, but he's got a whole big walk-in closet in his room.
No, it's basics, I think. It's just to be, not naked, you know, in the street, you know?
So not like your pictures.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
What's your favorite piece of
No, item? Just like, I've got one piece, actually, just because it represents
Guadeloupe, your hometown.
Exactly, so Caribbean, you know, it's not far from St. Lucie and stuff like this, but it means a lot because all my family is still down here.
Now, we know the brother plays football, but I mean, come on. This is like cheapest, man. Tog, food.
It's kind of collection as well. You see they're signed, you know, it's Tim Cahill there, you know, it's got boots I played and I like them, so I keep them, you know, in case. You know, you never know, any tournaments, I'm going to be there.
Okay, but now, you're not a goalkeeper, my brother. I see you've got goalkeeper gloves in here.
Timo Ward, you know, that's a special goalkeeper. I really enjoy playing with him. So,
pick your favorite sneakers for me besides your Tod's.
Oh, actually, in the summer, I use that a lot.
Yeah.
It's like very open, you know, and look at the special foot, you know.
Yeah, it keeps your big toe nice and safe exactly. There. Now, I see there are some drawers here.
Nothing.
You know? I'm kind of wondering, Africa, what is in these drawers? I'm going to let the man, because he's been saying ladies first.
I would be surprised, you know, but you're swimming, you know, like my kids in there. Yeah, you see?
Oh, okay.
Oh, family man here.
That's one.
Second one.
Off.
What is it? Nothing special.
What is this?
It's to have weight, you know, to make sure that I'm not dying on
Yeah, you're not overdoing it.
Yeah, exactly. Look. Collection again of shirts. I'm telling you, I'm a sporty man and I love football.
Okay, this is Nazri.
Special, huh?
He's got the man, Mr. DDA Drogba. These are obviously memorable to you, you know, they mean a lot to you.
Yeah, they're big players and it's a privilege to know them and sometimes have a chat how things are going, you know, so it's great to be involved with such personalities.
Well, it's time to join another great footballer of a different kind. Yo, Chris, what you got for us this week, man?
What's good, my people? Now, this week, I've got a very difficult and technical trick for you, and it's called Eclipse. This move is crazy difficult. It's inspired by the Twilight series, and you're going to sweat blood to get this move. Now, step one, juggle the ball, setting yourself up to a steady rhythm. Step two, jumping over the ball, catch with your dominant foot whilst flicking it behind you. Now, step three, gain control of the ball to complete the move.
The break, Louis and I go have a little fun with some of his toys. What's up? I'm chilling with Louis Saha at his holiday villa in Cannes, France. Now let's go outside and check out some of his rides, people.
So this is your beast right here?
Yeah, it is, yeah. Big beast.
Dude, I've never been on one of those yet. Do you have a key for it?
Just here.
Please, I want to go for a ride.
Just here. Up. Yeah, you seen my beast now? Yeah, let's see my baby now.
Alright, let's go. Damn! McLaren plays that cheeky smile you're giving me, man. Damn. Okay.
You can't open the door.
How do you open the door, man? Alright, open it up, man. I wanna see it.
Yeah, just try it first.
I did. Next thing I want to do, a classic move.
Yeah, it's strange, you know. It's just like I have to go on your side now.
To open mine as well. Oh, nice. Okay. Damn, man. Woo! Africa, beast. Say hello to the baby. Oh, man. How fast does it go? And most importantly, how fast have you taken this for a ride?
It's brand new, so I have to be really careful. You have to, you know, gradually go up to speed, you know, so can't go really, really fast, but don't worry.
Don't worry, you'll do it.
Yeah.
What made you go for the silver gray color?
Yeah, I wanted something like very, like kind of Batmobile, you know, very discreet, but something new as well, so it's kind of dark and I really like it.
Well, we like it too. It's been an awesome day here in Cairns. I gotta go shop. Okay, at least I gotta go window shop. I gotta see some celebs. And best of all, I got to hang out with a celeb himself. Louis Saha, salute.
Man, Louis, thank you so much, man.
It was a pleasure.
You know, for opening your home, your cars to us, and just your heart. Especially people at home got to see how humble you are. Speaking about the people at home, is there something that you'd like to say to the people that support you?
No, I just want to say thank you for all the support and the belief, and you know, to see them smiling, even the things are still hard and still things are not easy. The African people are amazing for giving such generosity. So it's great because I think back here we love you and we want to keep giving belief to your fight, and I'm really concerned about things that was going wrong in Africa, so we're fighting for you as well.
Man, all the best with your career, man.
Thank you very much.
We'll see you soon, eh?
It's been a pleasure.
Cool.
Wait a second. I'll sign a shirt for
Gold Diggers. Ah, that's dope. Yeah. Let's do that.
Yes.
To Gold Diggers for Mr. Louis Saha himself. Au revoir, my brother.
Take care, man. Fuck up a little something. I'll be the soul speaker. Hear me, Mr. Preacher.
I'll be the diva who can turn the bass a little deeper. I'll be my brother's keeper. I'll be. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. What a humble young man. You know, he's written a book and is inspiring all the African guys back home. Join me again another time. Peace.
Give it to me.